Hello, this video is going to be about log, a Rust library providing lightweight logging facade. So if you want to make your program look nice and professional, let me just show you what I've done. So if you've used Axum, you might think this looks very familiar, and I've even used the ASCII banner in the same style. So what it does is it gives you the option of using trace, debug, warn, info, etc. And you can see what's going on in real time. So the examples here are ready made for you, but there's no actual main function. So you can't just copy and paste this code and run it. You will need to cargo new project name. You need to do fn main. Also, this might catch you, I don't know, but there's a function. You don't need public, actually. You would if it was in another module, but so yak, obviously yak's not a standard data type, so what you need to do is just create a struct called yak. We'll also do an impl for yak as well. So yak, and then you've got a function where the yak trace commencing yak shaving razor located. It's okay razor, so it's running another function, which, or we're going to make it run another function which fetches the razor. It's a bit of a unusual example, but there's also a note here about how you can output your logging to key value pairs. You'd use survey as well, but for now let's just look at the code that I've done, and I'll put the link in the video description. You're welcome to copy it. You can clone it from my GitHub repo. I'll put that link in as well. So if we just go into main, actually before we do that, let's just look at we'll look at cargo. So I've added colored just for the colored output. Log, the version here is 0.4.21 as of around about the 17th of April 2024. And we're using simple logger. So you need to use a logger with log, if that makes sense. There's the list on here. So in order to produce log output, executables have to use a logger implementation compatible with the facade. There are many available, blah, blah, blah. So, yeah, I'm using simple logger, but you've got the env-log logger. So take your pick, but for this purpose, I'm just going with simple logger. Okay, right, code. Sorry about that. I digressed, but I thought it's always good just to see the cargo toml. Sometimes you're, especially depending on what your employer is or what your business is, you may not want to use certain crates, or you may want to keep to a minimum the crates that you use for kind of compliance. There are sort of attack vectors potentially with unknown crates or crates which aren't widely used, should we say. So that's the struct that we create to make the yak example work. So yak. So we've defined, or I've defined the struct. There's an impl here, which we're just going to print something to this, to the logger as well. And I've just put in a sleep just to kind of simulate an actual program running. Find razor, which just is a function which just returns okay with sharp razor. So it's all very contrived, but what it does do is it kind of gives you the skeleton for, and also just trace, debug, warn. I think I added debug, so their example just had info, trace, warn. If you come from like a networking background, you'll know there's or what any background really. There's seven levels to the logging typically, so emergency info, warning, notification, so on, so debug. So yeah, there we go. That's the main code. We've got the loop where we match on find a razor, which is that function, and obviously it returns okay with sharp razor, and then razor located, and then razor is whatever's there inside the okay. Inside the okay we had that, which was a string, and yeah, it was a string if it was okay. If it wasn't, then it was a string literal of an error. And that's just where I've put in the banner at the end, so that's kind of cosmetic really. Little side note actually, if that wasn't there, you could just have had, if you didn't want to use colored, that would work as well. Let's just go execute. See, it's in white and it's saying it's not using colored. So if you've got your banner and it's all nicely lined up and you don't want to break anything, all you need to do is just go here, add. That's not going to alter any of the alignment. And after that last comma, just there, you just then do, what was it? Green. Let's just clear this. It's getting messy. There you go, back to green again. So all I did that you saw, well, no need to, you can rewind if you want to see what I did, but basically all I did was just put that there, plus a comma, and then the green at the end. Careful when you paste in, it's best just to use R for raw, and then you'll preserve the formatting and the spacing, especially with ASCII art. It can very quickly, you know, just one tab there, one space can really, I think it came in like that actually, so I just had to backspace it and that made it look good. So there we go, that's just my little quick whistle stop tour of using log. So you need to use log and effectively a logger which will display to the screen as of April 2024. We're on 0.421. It's actively maintained 2 weeks ago. I always like to see something that's kind of maintained within the past weeks or month or two, really. Obviously, this is really widely used. And, there we go. So, structured logging. Sorry, structured logging. If you want that, then you just need to add the feature when you add log to your cargo.toml. See what they've done there. But this is actually for the actual logger itself. But there you go. You've got key value, Serde unstable Serde. So yeah, you need to add Serde if you want to use key values. Yeah, good. So there we go. Learning Rust. Don't forget to thumbs up, like, subscribe, and all the usual stuff. Thanks for watching. I'll be back very soon.